counting down to first pitch at Citi Field. It's the Marlins and the Mets next on the show. Now from Citi Field in Flushing, New York, we welcome you to another edition of Baseball on the Show. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series between the Miami Marlins and the New York Mets. Welcome in, everybody. Matt Vaskirjan here to bring you this early season matchup. I'm joined by Eric Karros and the newest member of our team, Steve Lyons, as we delve into our pitching matchup here in the opener.
Yeah, and as you look at the numbers here, we've still got a guy looking for his very first victory on the season. Ideally, he'd have one by now, but some of it's been his own problems, and some of it can be attributed to the lack of run support. But however you look at it, you know he'd love to get that first W under his belt.
More from the guys as this one goes along, but first, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Miami Marlins. As their starting nine tonight will look like this. They'll go to work against a guy once involved in a deadline deal for Carlos Beltran, the electric right-hander Zach Wheeler. Christian Yelich makes his way to the plate now as we're just about set for baseball this evening. And the fastball here is hit on the ground but foul.
First pitch, 7-10.
Now he drops one down here right out in front of the plate. And the throw will be too late, so it's a bunt single to get him started here. So the leadoff man is aboard to start the series. And with that, let's take a look now at how the Mets will set things up on defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Donovan Solano will stand in now, and he'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out. Big hole on the right side. Here's the first pitch. Pitch inside. The throw is there, and he's out trying to take second.
Well, he did a good job to get on base with the leadoff single, but then he got a little greedy here on the first pitch, and they throw him out pretty easily at second base.
The 1-0. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now.
This is kind of an important start for that guy right there. He hasn't been all that great to start the year. Needs to come up with a good outing to get him back on track.
Lays off a fastball, but it's over for a strike. 2-1.
Boy, good pitch, good spot. That thing tailed right back over the outside corner.
Now a ball lined hard toward right center, and that is going to be a base hit.
This is all about taking what's given to you as a hitter. They want to keep working you away? Fine, let them. You just have to take the approach like this. Drive it to the opposite field. Now they'll think twice about working you out there next time.
Giancarlo Stanton will get his first shot now with the runner at first following the one-out single. Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
Shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
Ball swing, and he takes this the other way to right. But this will hang just long enough for him to run it down in shallow right for the second out.
You got to think about the time of night out there. You've got shadows still lingering a little bit. The lights haven't quite taken full effect yet. But he's all over this one, and he takes it down easily.
Garrett Jones will take his first swings here. And as you can see, not a lot going right for him offensively here in this first month of the year. Now this is chopped fouled at home plate. It's 0-1. Two out with the man at first. Now a ball hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line. Quintanilla is there, and the side is retired. One left for Miami. And now the Mets offense will go to work for the first time. No score. Now here's the starting lineup for the Mets as put forward by manager Terry Collins. And there's a look at the starter this lineup will match up against as you take a look at his line on the right side of your screen. And in the field, the Marlins will align themselves like this. Eric Young Jr. will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first. And this one runs up high, ball one. Chop fouled off to the right side. Sharply hit back up the middle, and the leadoff man is going to reach here. He's got a base hit.
So far, so good. They get a scoreless top of the first, and now a leadoff single to start things in their half.
Ruben Tejada will stand in for the first time, and you see the numbers there as he's done well during this 10-game streak. And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one. Running is Young. Pitches a called strike. The throw is not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw.
And this is one of those guys that can certainly be an X factor in this series. He sets a tone early here with a first inning steal of second base.
Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-2. For Young, he picks up his fifth stolen base on the campaign. Fastball swung on and hit on the ground at third. And Wigginton's throw is in time for out number one.
You know, usually I'm going to jump on the hitters when they fail to move runners over, but hey, look, that pitcher, he did a good job. I mean, he knows what they're trying to do, so he makes it as tough as possible to hit the ball to the right side. That's using your head out there.
Daniel Murphy will be the batter. And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. Young leads off second, the pitch. Here's one that misses high. It's one and one. And he lays off for a ball, two and one. Goes the other way as this is down the line at third. Throw on to the first baseman. Jones is in time. Two away now.
Batting fourth, left fielder.
Curtis Granderson will get his first opportunity here with the leadoff man still at second, but with two gone now. Getting a few steps off a second there. Now the pitch. Now a curveball that misses here to the cleanup man. It's 1-0. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Now a ball lined to the right side. That's in there. Base hit. Young around third, heading for the plate. The tag, and he is out at the plate. So much for our first run of the ball game. Mets lead one. After one, no score. Ty Wigginton leads things off now in the top half of the second.
Third baseman, Ty Wigginton.
First pitch coming. And this is fouled back and out of play. And he takes strike two. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Well, one thing you can always say when you're facing a guy like this is that he's gonna strike hitters out. The question is, are you gonna make him work for those strikeouts? And if those three pitches are any indication at all, these guys could be in for a long night.
Reed Johnson will dig in now, and he's gotta be wondering when his bat's gonna make the trip north from spring training, as he has really struggled in the early going. First pitch is a slider down low. It's 1-0. And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. And this is going to be a foul ball in amongst the spectators. Right there, Murphy at second. Throw on to first is in time, and Johnson is retired for the second out of the inning.
Batting seven, catcher, Jared Saltalamacchia.
Jared Saltalamacchia will stand in here looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Yeah, you know, first time through, he likes to start guys off with a fastball. And it's a good one, too. You know, he'll run it up there in the mid-90s.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. He ties him up with a fastball inside, 1-2.
Yeah, and you know, this is a spot where you just have to make him bring the ball down. It's very difficult to do anything positive when it's up that high.
To two balls and two strikes now. That's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
Now a check swing here, and no swing, says the home plate umpire. Not even an appeal. It's ball four.
Rafael Percol.
Rafael Furcal will dig in now. Off to a slow start, as you see there, just barely over the 200 mark here in April. And here's a called strike to the 36-year-old veteran. It's nothing and one.
And after a walk, I think there's a little anger behind that fastball.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Well, no taken now. He's going to have to swing the bat.
Here comes Wheeler's 0-2. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Out of play, off to the right. No score here as we play inning number two. Throw over to the bag, and the runner back safely. Tried to throw the fastball by him, but it's high, 1-2.
Could be that that high fastball there was just a setup pitch. Now you've kind of established that high sight level. Could be a good time to break off a nasty curveball.
And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. Just does stay alive as this is fouled back. That's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
And you know what, guys? This is a big league battle going on right now. Neither guy wanting to back down. No sign of weakness on either side.
And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
And now the benefit of you working the count to 3-2 is that that runner gets a head start from first with two away.
And now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to fairly deep right field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And the opening salvo is fired here as they take a 1-0 lead.
Well, he gives this ball a pretty good ride. No shot to get this one as it's going to wind up hitting on the track and one hop in the wall out there. He's going to wind up pulling into second with an RBI double.
Tom Kohler will get a chance to swing away, and he'll have a chance to pad onto his lead if he can deliver something here with two away. And a half-hearted swing there as he tried to go the other way, and it's strike one.
And even after the two-out RBI, you still have a chance to help yourself out here with a hit. You got a man in scoring position.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
And you can't make this easy on him right here. At least make some contact and force him to make a play.
And this is fouled into the seats over from first. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. Marlins get a run on the RBI double. We'll go to the bottom of the second. It's now 1-0 Miami. Mike Davis will stand in as one of the stars from yesterday's ball game as he had three hits in the victory. And there's his strike right down the heart of the plate, 0-1. Davis, the subject of seemingly endless trade rumors in the offseason, but he's back with the Mets after having a rough go of it last year. Wound up spending a few weeks in AAA and finished at just 205 with 9 home runs after hitting 32 the year before. And this is going to be a foul ball. Still sticking with the fastball, but this time he lays off. It's 1-2.
On 0-2, if that's a curveball, a changeup, a sinker, then maybe you get a guy to chase. But it's much easier to lay off a pitch down there when it's a straight fastball.
1-2 is an off-speed pitch. No dice. It's 2-2. Swing and a ball hit to the left side, and this is going to wind up a souvenir. The 2-2 one more time. And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. Lined hard to center field. Dives, and he hangs on for the out. Wow!
Boy, that's just great concentration right there. You can see the extension, and he really sells out for this one, and he's able to absorb the impact and hold on to the baseball. That's a sweet play.
Lucas Duda will stand in. He's got that average pushing up near 300 to start the new season. Fouled back. Good change up there as he takes command 0-2.
Hard to believe he let that one go. I mean, that was right on a platter for him.
Bases are empty, one man out. On a big curveball is in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone.
Batting seventh,
Omar Quintanilla will get his first chance now, trying to get something started with two away here in the bottom of the second. Swing and a shot back up the middle. Oh, and that drills him on the mound as it veers off towards short. But the recovery throw will be in time to first. Good job that time of not giving up on the play, and the inning is over. Christian Yelich is ready to go here as we begin the third.
Left fielder, Christian Yelich.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Sticks with the fastball here as he forges ahead 0-2.
Yeah, he has been patient up there, but now he's backed himself into a corner.
And a waste pitch there, 1-2.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
And that's going to be high, 2-2 now.
2-2.
Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one.
Now, once the sun goes down here, this place plays like a much different ballpark. Case in point right there. That ball had no carry whatsoever.
Donovan Solano will dig in. He singled his first time around. And this is going to be a foul ball. Lean out of the way there. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that eye.
And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Now a foul tip at the plate, and you could hear that one ring off the catcher's mask as he stays alive. Oh, and a good curveball that time as it's taken for a called strike three, and there are two away.
And I can tell you, from facing guys like this my whole career, you may think you're getting a curveball, but when a guy's throwing in the high 90s, it's darn near impossible to sit on one.
Giancarlo Stanton will stand in, a lineout victim his first time. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. Now a check swing here, but the home plate umpire says he went around, and no argument, and it's 1-1. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. That's on the ground to short. This should end the inning. On to play it is Tejada. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. Miami down in order. But they're on top, 1-0. Travis d'Arnaud makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number 3. Here's the first offering. Fastball in there for a called strike. Check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball one. Here's a shot over the second baseman's head, and that's going to plug the gap. Good for extra bases. He's around first on his way to second now. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
Yeah, good chance to get that early run right back. This is a great swing right here. The drive just went all the way out to the wall, and he's into second with a leadoff double.
Zach Wheeler will step in, and with nobody out, we'll see if they want to let him swing the batter, try to bunt that runner onto third. Infield expecting bunt. Here's the first pitch. And they'll try to get the man to third as he puts this one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice.
And that's exactly what you want out of your pitcher. No long at bat, get in, get it down, and get out of there. And on one pitch, he's able to get the job done.
Eric Young Jr. will stand in. He singled to lead off the home first. And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate. Any thought to bringing the infield in here with one away?
Still a little early in my book. A run you can live with. What you don't want to do is let this snowball into a big inning.
Two balls, no strikes now, batting with one out and a runner at third.
Oof. That high fastball is definitely a pitch guys will pop up, and that's what he's looking for on the mound. So that's good restraint to hold back and not swing.
Both clubs with 3 hits in the ballgame. 3-0 now.
Well, if he's missing right here, he ain't missing by much. Not getting too many favors behind the plate.
And they were simply not going to give him anything there with the base open. It's a four-pitch walk.
I would imagine that free pass was at least semi-intentional there. Now at least you set up a double play possibility with runners at the corners and one out.
Ruben Tejada will stand in. He grounded out his first time. In there, no balls and a strike.
Yeah, and with two on now following the walk, he needed to jump ahead of the next guy, so that's a good way to start out.
On the ground for call, this could be two. Solano for one, on to first, but not in time. He beats it out to keep the inning alive, and the run is in to score.
And with one away, they were hoping to get the double play up the middle to get him out of this. But they wind up only getting one on the play as that run comes home to score on the fielder's choice.
Daniel Murphy will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First pitch is a slider down low. It's 1-0. And the fastball hitting 93 on the gun. It's 1-1. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2.
Let's go, New York.
1-2. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
See you, man. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Ready with another 2-2. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number 3. Some more of the colorful characters here at the ballpark tonight. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Garrett Jones will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
First baseman, Garrett Jones.
Come on, Matt.
High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. And he watches one split the middle here, 1-1.
Oh, man, he must have been looking for something else. That was a curveball that had "hit me" written all over it, and he couldn't pull the trigger.
The 1-1 now to Jones. Up high, 2-1 now. Two and two now. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth.
Now batting, third baseman, Ty Wigginton.
Ty Wigginton will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one.
Straight paint at 94 miles an hour. Not a lot of movement there, but it's right on a dime.
Here's a swing and a ground ball. Therefore, it is Quintanilla. On to first now as Wigginton's gone for out number two. Reed Johnson will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Now here's the first pitch. Started to go around, but it's ruled strike one anyway. And he gets on top of this one and sends it on the ground to short. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth, tied 1-1. Curtis Granderson will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
I think if you gave him another chance, he'd be swinging at that one. That was a great pitch to hit.
Fouled straight back. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Don't quite know where that one missed, but it's not for me to decide. 3-2. Waiting on deck is Ike Davis.
You can do it.
Now here's the pitch. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
Third strikeout for him now. Got him out front a little bit here. He winds up turning this pitch over nicely, and he gets him to swing right through it.
One away, and here's the power-hitting first baseman, Ike Davis. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. Fastball misses inside. It's even at one. One out, nobody on. Davis waits on the 1-1. And this ball will be chopped foul. Swing and a high chopper towards first. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line.
And for a first baseman, if the most direct route is to just tag the guy, that's what you do. There's no sense in trying to throw it to your pitcher or your second baseman covering, especially if you don't have to.
Lucas Duda will dig in here. Took a called third strike his first time. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
After the strikeout his first time around, I think he was able to use that first at bat as a learning experience. Those have both been real good takes.
Might have been ball three there, but he couldn't resist trying to pull that thing. And good contact there as this is hit high and deep to right center. Around first, on his way to second now. And now that'll hop over the wall. So he'll be at second here with two away on a ground rule double. Omar Quintanilla will step in. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. Just onto the outfield grass as he makes the stop. Throw in time and the side is retired. Danger averted following the two-out double. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Jared Saltalamacchia will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Jared Saltalamacchia.
And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1.
He's just cruising out there now. I'll tell you, this may turn into a game of first team to two wins.
On they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
That got in his kitchen big time right there.
Popped him up over to the left, but playable over in foul ground. He'll try again, 1-2. Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. Swing and a miss there as the breaking ball takes care of him for the first out.
Yeah, doesn't look like much has changed here to start this inning either. That's eight in a row now he's set down.
One away now for the Marlins in their half of the fifth. And here's the table setter, Rafael, for call. And this is fouled back and out of play. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
Here's an easy strikeout.
Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. Now here's the pitch. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
Well, I'd be surprised if they go back to the curve again on 2-2. He's had a couple of pretty good looks at it at the plate.
And he tried to hold up that time. We'll get an appeal down to third, and no swing. It's ball three. 3-2, here it comes. Toward the gap in right center, this is going to be a base hit, and he may take that big turn at first. And he can't come up with it cleanly here in right. Furcal's going to try for third. And Furcal's going to be in there safely at third as he's got himself a triple.
Just settle down now.
And even after the redesign, one thing about playing here at Citi Field, from gap to gap, there's an awful lot of room to cover out there. So you find an opening, you can run for days, and he's into third here with three bases.
Tom Kohler will stand in with a golden chance here to help himself out with a runner at third.
And he knows this is a definite strikeout situation. So the big key here is, at the very least, find a pitch you can put in play.
Late on the fastball there as this one skied out towards straightaway right. Duda has it, and I'd be surprised if they send the runner. And they will tag him out at the plate. And that'll keep our ball game tied up as the inning is over. No damage done after the two-out triple. More in a moment on the show, the Friday Night Showcase. Travis d'Arnaud will stand in to lead things off in the bottom of the fifth.
Catcher, Travis d'Arnaud.
And a ball, 1-0. And he gets around on the fastball here as this is hit fairly well out toward left field. Yelich able to take this one in, and there's your first out.
Now batting, the pitcher, Zach Wheeler.
Zach Wheeler will dig in. No official at bat yet as he delivered a sacrifice bunt in his first appearance. Now the first pitch. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes.
Come on, New York.
Swing and a miss as he gets this fastball by him. It's 1-1. Big breaking ball and a beauty that time, 1-2.
Good curveball right there, and that just really froze him.
to 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
And you know, he's been the beneficiary of most of the calls here tonight, but I think that's one that he thought he should have had.
And this is fouled straight back. Full count now, 3-2.
Boy, you have got to make this guy swing the bat here on this next pitch. This is not the guy you want to lose.
Hits are now even at 4 apiece. And he misses here, ball 4. And somehow he manages to walk his opposite number. Wow.
You can't fault the pitch selection or the location there. And it's well placed, maybe just a hair off the outside corner. But 3-2, that's where you want to be.
Eric Young Jr. will stand in. Base on balls his last time. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1.
Pretty good speed here coming out of that left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
Come on, get the runner to second.
That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count.
Yeah, he must have been looking for that same breaking ball because that pitch, it's right there.
And a change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
And with a runner on first, you better have a catcher that you can rely on if you're going to bounce a change up on an 0-2 count. Luckily, he does.
Come on.
And a good swing there as this is deep down the line and right, but this is going to wind up out of play. 1 run, 4 hits. And no errors on the Mets line score so far. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Swing hard liner to left center, and he is going to reach. It's a base hit. Throw comes back in quickly, so put the runners at first and second now, still with only one away. Ruben Tejada stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball.
Now a ball bounced towards the mound. Solano for one. On to Jones. Not in time. And they'll just get the one.
And here's why you always go in hard at second base. This could be a very easy double play ball. But you see the aggressive slide here. That really impacts the throw to first. And they wind up getting just one on that play. Excellent aggressive base running.
Daniel Murphy. See what he can do here with 2 on and 2 out here in inning number 5. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. On to first, and the Mets are going to come up empty here as that ends the inning. 2 left for the Mets. We've played 5 full, tied at 1 aside.
Christian Yelich
will stand in to lead things off as the Marlins look to get things started here in their half of the sixth.
Christian Yelich.
Runs up to bunt here, but he missed it for strike one. Tries to drop one down here, but he misses. Strike two. Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, one and two. And a swing and a bouncing ball back up the middle. And oh no, pray that didn't get him where it sounded like it got him. Carlos Torres will be summoned now to take over following the injury. Donovan Solano will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher, as he'll do so with the runner at first and nobody out. Starts him out with a curveball for a strike.
Not a bad idea to take a look at that one there. Now that you've seen the curveball, you can start to get a better gauge on it. Get a feel for what it looks like coming out of the pitcher's hand.
Okay, pitcher.
And that one cut a little too much, a ball and a strike. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. And this is on the ground toward the hole. And that's through into left field for a base hit. And the runner holds at second, so they're at first and second now with nobody out.
There you go. Back-to-back singles here to open up the inning, have him set up in a good position to break this deadlock.
Giancarlo Stanton will step in. He's lined out and grounded out in two trips.
Right here, right now.
They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one.
Whoa, that one definitely took off on him right there. He's lucky that thing didn't go all the way to the backstop.
Good lead off a second there. Now the pitch. Ball two.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in a strike zone.
And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Good time to call the change as he swings and misses for strike two.
Yeah, looked like he guessed right on 2-1. That was a good time to swing for the fences.
And this is low, but it's corralled quickly, and both runners will have to hang on. Close to the bag at second there. Now the pitch. And he misses with it, ball four, so that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
Well, we knew he had to work carefully with the runner in scoring position, but I don't think a walk was what he had in mind. That's going to make things just a little trickier now with the bases loaded.
Garrett Jones will try it again. 0 for 2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far. Now the first pitch. Cut fastball taken for strike one.
You cannot let this situation get any worse. You got to be thinking strikeout or ground ball. Even if you allow one run to score in this inning, that would be a major victory.
And low, it's a ball and a strike.
And if he thought he was in a mess when he came into the game, he's really in a mess now.
Now a swing and a ground ball back up the middle. And that is into center field as he comes through. It's a base hit.
Third baseman number 8, Ty.
Kyle Farnsworth will take over on the mound now here in the sixth inning.
New York Mets, number 44, Kyle Farnsworth.
Ty Wigginton will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. There's a fastball missing down and away for a ball, 1-0. Oh, and trouble lurking now. He's got it to 2-0. Eric, what are you looking for here?
It's a fastball count, but he doesn't always play by the rules out there, so this could very well be a slider or something away. So, in other words, I have no idea.
3-0 now. The alarm bells are ringing now.
They're getting louder and louder, too.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. First and second here with nobody out. 3-1 on the way. And there's a called strike at the knees as he was hoping for a base on balls there, but it's a full count now, 3-2. And he'll fight just to stay alive here as this is fouled away. And the payoff pitch is chopped foul at home plate, so we'll do it again. Still 3-2. Swing and a ball lifted into straightaway center. Young is there and he has it for the first out.
Yeah, that was a really good battle right there. It took him a lot of pitches to finally get the fly ball out. Now, obviously you're not going to get on base, but I wouldn't consider that a wasted at bat at all.
Reed Johnson will stand in again. A couple of ground outs for him on the ledger in his two trips so far. Now both runners on the move, and this will be fouled away. Checked his swing there. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball one. Grounded foul toward the coaching box at third. Stanton leads off of second. The pitch. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Runners are at first and second with one away. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2. Jared Saltalamacchia waits on deck. And awfully close there on 3-2, but take your base, says Earl Hendricks. It's ball four.
The catcher, number 39, Jared Saltalamacchia.
Jared Saltalamacchia will try again. Struck out swinging his last time through. First pitch coming. Cut fastball in there for a called strike.
And this guy's been in situations like this so many times before. He's got plenty to call on upstairs to try to help him work out of this jam.
And he takes this one high, 1-1.
Very tempting up there, but that's also a pitch that a lot of guys will pop up. So that's a nice job of laying off.
Three runs, seven hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. A little bit outside, 2-1.
Well, he's starting to put himself into a no-win situation. Obviously, you don't want to walk home a run, but you can't just throw a cookie in there because he could bring in four with one swing.
Swing and a line drive to center field. And he will deliver one of the biggest at-bats of the night. It's a base hit. And that'll plate the runner from third, as with that, the lead swells to 4-1.
The shortstop, number 15, Rafael Furcal.
Rafael Furcal will stand in. Two hits in two trips thus far. And he hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike one.
Yeah, definitely taken all the way. Not a bad idea with the bases loaded.
Three runs already home here. And a swing as he pulls this one into right. Duda is there. Let's see if they test it. And there will be no attempt to score here as the bases stay loaded with two gone now.
Wow, now that's just a tough break right there. If this gets down, it's one run, maybe even two. But it was hit just a little bit too hard there, and it's sent back into the infield very quickly, forcing all three runners to hold right where they were.
Jose Valverde will get the call here in a big spot as he inherits a bases-loaded jam with two men out. Tom Kohler will stand in now with the bases loaded, two away, and a chance to really help himself out.
And at the very least, he's got to focus on getting something in play. He can really help himself out with just a simple single here.
Let's get out of this inning.
First pitch on the way. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. Bases are loaded here, two down. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. And it looks now like a right-hander's begun to get loose in the Mets bullpen. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. And they get the force at home. Whatever works, as the side is retired. So all in all, they're fortunate to give up just three in the inning as they wind up escaping the bases-loaded jam. On to the... Curtis Granderson will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6, as they try to get something going.
And this whole lineup's been pretty quiet all game long. Just the one run, that's it.
Here we go. foul toward the third base dugout, but this will get back into the seats out of play. And he lays off for ball one. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Fouled back. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Yeah, it's a good battle to start this inning. That's what you like to see when you've got a guy out there that's getting up there in the pitch count.
Now a swing, and he popped him up. And no ordinary pop-up at that. This is way up there. Near the stands, and he brings this one back in. He took that right out of the first row. Wow.
And his control's been real good here into the middle innings now. You'll see where this pitch is. Another great location right on the corner, and he gets him to pop it up.
Now a ball lined to the left side, but this is a foul ball. Oh, and he looks like he's toying with him here. It's 0-2. For that man right there, you need look back only to his last start to see a performance like the one he's shown here so far.
And well on his way to another great outing. And that's what you get when you mix your speeds and throw a lot of strikes.
Ball swung on and hit high down the line in left, but it'll get back in among the crowd, so the count holds at 0-2. Another 0-2 coming. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
He's been able to get outs when he needs them with that curveball, and there you see what his pitch breakdown has been so far.
Lucas Duda will stand in. He's 1-for-2 so far. Now here's the first pitch. Low for ball one. For that man right there, just the one run allowed. The question is, can he make that lead stand up?
Well, he hasn't shown too many signs of cracking so far. He's got the look of someone right now who's ready to go the distance.
And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. Swing, and he popped him up over in foul territory back behind third. Wigginton is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Mets. They trail it 4-1. Welcome back to Citi Field in Flushing. It's on to the seventh inning with the Marlins on top, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first six innings of play. Christian Yelich will lead it off here in the top of inning number seven.
Left fielder, Christian Yelich.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0.
Oh, come on.
Ball went about halfway there, but it's a called strike regardless. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
Now he was really late on this one. I mean, really late. You can see where the baseball is by the time he gets the barrel through. I mean, it's darn near in the catcher's glove already. That tells me he was probably looking for something else.
Donovan Solano will get another shot now, 2-for-3 in the game. Here's the first offering. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Fastball here as he pops him up back behind second base. And this will be taken in without much trouble. It's an easy start to the seventh. Two gone.
Well, sometimes when you miss with your location, it actually works to your benefit. I mean, this pitch is further up than I think he wants it, but hey, it works out for him.
Giancarlo Stanton will stand in here. 0-for-2 with a run scored so far. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Right on that pitch that time as he wraps it into center field, a base hit.
Boy, and how he managed to get enough on this swing to get it into the outfield, it's beyond me. I mean, this is pure muscle right here because that ball is nowhere close to the barrel of the bat.
Garrett Jones will be the batter. He singled home a couple in his last at-bat. Here's the first pitch to him. Now here's a ball hit sharply toward the right side. And that's in there, base hit. Throw will hold that runner at second base, and now there are two on with two out.
Well, he's been a little slow out of the blocks here to start the season, but that looks a little better there as this is a sharp base hit.
Ty Wigginton will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here. All
A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
Now he's going to have to punch his way off the ropes now.
And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. And just fire that thing in there.
Let's go, Matt.
We're in the seventh now. 4-1 our score to this point.
Shut him down now.
Lays off the splitter that time, and it's two balls and a strike.
A two-out hit here would be nice, but a two-out walk wouldn't be the worst thing in the world either.
Keeping him close there at second. Now the pitch into center field. That's going to get down for a base hit. Around third and being waved on home. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Marlins strand a pair, but they lead it 4-1. Omar Quintanilla will step in now to lead off the home half of the seventh. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Well, the guy you see right there calling the shots has opted to roll with his starter here to begin his half of the seventh.
And that pitch count is a concern, so he may get the chance to finish this inning off and then call it a night.
On a swing, and he popped him up off to the left in foul territory. And this is taken in for out number one.
Yeah, two pitches, one out. And that's how you want to start an inning when you're already over 90 pitches for the ballgame.
Travis d'Arnaud will stand in. He flew out his last time up. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And here's the first pitch. Grounded foul off to the right and over toward the dugout. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
1-1.
And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. Up with it is Percaw. Throw on to the first baseman. Jones is in time. Two away now. David Wright will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. EK, the starter, creeping up on 100 pitches now, but that number alone doesn't appear to be affecting him too much at all.
Yeah, he still looks sharp. Still, with the way that teams handle pitchers nowadays, I don't think he'll wind up going much further.
1-0 on the way. Now a swing and a ground ball. Right there is Wigginton, and that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Mets go down 1-2-3, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Daisuke Matsusaka will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Daisuke Matsusaka.
Reed Johnson will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Action in the Mets bullpen now. It's both a lefty and a right-hander that start to throw. Hard hit to third. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8.
Well, you can tell the third baseman's playing a little bit in front of the bag right here, trying to take away that bunt. Unfortunately, this ball almost takes his teeth out. The reactions had to be quick, and lucky for him, he's still got them.
Jared Saltalamacchia will dig in again. He singled home a run his last time. First pitch coming. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0.
And think about it, in game one of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend.
Water, get your water here.
That missed close. It's ball two.
Yeah, a little unlucky here to be behind 2-0. Those first couple of pitches haven't missed by a whole lot.
Outside, 3-0 now.
And that questionable call on the previous pitch, it really changes the at-bat because he doesn't want to just lay one in there on 2-0. Now it's 3-0, and the tide is not working in his favor.
And that misses as well. Ball four, so it's a four-pitch walk here.
The shortstop, number 15.
Rafael Furcal will dig in. He lined out hard in his last time around. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. And oh dear, that caught him full bore on the mound as it ricochets back toward the plate. And they'll try to salvage something here, but to no avail. And now we'll have to check and see if he's okay.
Tom Kohler.
Rob Brantley will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 19, Rob Brantley.
Ball hit high to the right side, but this will get into the seats foul. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at 1.
Well, be careful not to airmail that thing over your catcher's head. You got to make sure you don't overthrow it.
No lead to speak of at second. Here's the pitch. Called strike two on the cutter, and he's behind in the count now, 1-2. Hit hard to the right, but foul. Eighth inning, 4-1 is our score. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. Not much of a lead at second. Now here's the pitch. Cut fastball misses 2-2. Now here's another pitch fouled off and heading for the seats, and he's just fighting to stay alive here, still 2-2. Look out, don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches, he's laid off a few pitches like that one, and now he's worked his way back to a 3-2 count.
started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone.
Yeah, that's a tough pitch there, 3-2. It probably would have been ball four, but I'm not sure if I could have laid off that one either.
Christian Yelich will stand in with a showdown looming. Two on, two out here in inning number eight. Too low, 1-0.
And this is a critical point right here. Things are in danger of getting away from you, so you gotta suck it up.
Two men are on with two men out. Short lead from second, now the pitch. And clearly trying to keep the ball low here, that's ball two.
And now at the plate with a 2-0 count, it's not just, hey, this has to be a strike. You've got to look for one pitch in one location and then let it rip.
Sweet. Line hard, but this will be a foul ball. Now a hard liner, but foul. Runner not going anywhere at second. Now the pitch. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Marlins strand a pair as they hold on to a 4-1 lead. A.J. Ramos is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth. A.J. Ramos. Eric Young Jr. will lead things off here in the bottom half of inning number eight. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And he takes ball one. Now a swing and a high fly ball, and this one has some carry on it to deep right field. Therefore, it is Stanton, and he's got it for the first out. Ruben Tejada will stand in. He grounded into a fielder's choices last time. And here's a ball hit in the air. Jones is under it, and Tejada's gone on just one pitch.
As a manager, you love your relievers to come in and give you plenty of strikeouts. But I'll tell you what, there isn't a manager alive that'll get upset when you come in and get two outs on three pitches.
Daniel Murphy will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ballgame are growing dimmer by the batter.
Here's a fastball called for strike one.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Yeah, and if you got him to look at the first pitch up there, why not throw it again? Also letter high. That puts him in a quick 0-2 hole.
And a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Mets. They trail it 4-1. Dylan G will come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth. Donovan Solano will get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth.
Second baseman, Donovan Solano.
Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. He'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit.
Yeah, he's not trying to hit him, I don't think, but sometimes you need to keep guys honest up there. I think that's all he was trying to do there.
Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Here's another 1-2. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and yes, he went around. It's strike three.
Just overmatched him there. It's a 1-2 fastball, and this is right by him. Absolutely no contest.
Giancarlo Stanton will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one.
Yeah, showing no fear there. He put the pitch right at the letters away, but that guy didn't want any part of it.
And he drops that one in for strike two.
One thing you've got to be aware of as a hitter is he's going to give you a bit of a variety up there. He's got five pitches, and he's going to use all of them.
And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Way out in front as this is yanked foul into the seats in left. Swing, but it's strike three anyway, says the home plate umpire, and that's out number two.
And here this is one more time on show track. You can see he checked his swing there, and I think he did so in time, but you can clearly see that that pitch is in the strike zone, and I think ultimately that was a called third strike.
Garrett Jones will stride in. He singled in his last plate appearance. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
And on the mound here, you got to make sure you pitch to the shift. You don't want to make it easier for a guy to go the other way on you.
Swing and a hot shot toward third. And that gets down, and we'll see if that's extra bases. And he is in the second with a double, his third hit of the night.
Well, you'll see how late he is on this fastball. I mean, he nearly takes this out of the catcher's glove, but somehow he's able to steer it fair down the line, and he cruises in with a double.
So a runner at second, two down now, and standing in the third baseman, Ty Wigginton. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch, but you got to do it. You can't give up that inside corner, or this guy will eat you alive.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Tough pitches here, back to back. And now he's not going to give him anything good with a runner at second base.
And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. The next 0-2. Now here's a fastball up that he sends in the air out to fairly deep center field. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Marlins leave one, but they lead it 4-1. Steve Cishek is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
Number 31, Steve Cishek.
Curtis Granderson will stand in. He flew out his last time up.
Here in the bottom of the ninth, left fielder, Curtis Granderson.
Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
Yeah, nice to get that call right out of the bullpen.
And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Now a ball sprayed fouled into the seats near third. Granderson waits on the 1-2, and just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here, one away.
Now this bullpen's picking right up where their starter left off. This has been a real team effort on the mound.
Ike Davis will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. The first pitch here is below the knees, but he gets him to chase it, and it's 0-1. You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Connie squares up on this one as it's hit high and deep out to straightaway right field. And this game just got a little more interesting. This is a home run. It's Ike Davis here with the solo home run. And the Mets draw closer here. It's now a 4-2 ball game.
One rule for being a successful closer, you gotta keep the ball in the ballpark. He's still got a lead to work with after this home run, but his margin for error is pretty much gone now.
Lucas Duda will stand in. He popped out in his last time. And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Now here's the first pitch. First pitch here is a sinker that runs a bit too wide. It's ball one.
They're definitely making him work out there. He came in trying to shut the door, and he has not had an easy time of it.
That's right, good eye.
Out of play off to the right, it's 1-1. Here's the 1-1. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. Hard sinker misses 2-2. And this is going to be a foul ball. Another try at 2-2. Now a ball lined to the right side. In there, a base hit. Omar Quintanilla will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one.
And you know, his changeup and sinker sort of do the same thing. They both drop off the table pretty good at the end. The only difference is he usually wants you to hit his sinker, and he wants you to swing and miss at the changeup.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Two sinkers down in the zone. No surprise what they're after here.
Yeah, and this guy's no dummy at the plate. He knows exactly what they're trying to do. It's not like he just fell off the turnip truck.
Now here's a ball hit high and deep out to left center field. Johnson is there to take it, and that's the second out of the inning.
Yeah, I thought this one was going to be two, maybe even three off the bat. But take a look from this angle at how much room he's covering out there in center field. I mean, that's as good a jump as you're ever going to see.
Travis d'Arnaud is the last chance now with two out here in the ninth. One. Nervous time now in that third base dugout.
Heck, nervous time up here. My heart's racing, and I'm just watching this game.
Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. Sinker dips too low there, into the dirt, in fact. It's been much harder work than I think he anticipated.
Yeah, he came in here trying to shut the door, and he has not had an easy time of it at all.
And this is cut on and missed, so the Mets are down to their final strike now. A runner on first with two away. And he strikes him out to end it here, as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Well, he did serve up the home run here to make this one a little bit more interesting. But in the end, he does get the job done, and he nails down the save.
Before we take our leave, time for a look at our final line score here in what turned out to be a close two-run victory. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
And this is what you want out of your starter. Gives him seven strong innings, sets things up perfectly for his bullpen to get the final six out. He's going to walk away with a victory. Good job.
So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. And for more, click on over to theshownation.com. The Marlins win it 4-2. Good night from Flushing.